First of all, I think Africa faces an identity crisis. And sometimes we do not seem to accept ourselves for who we are. And if we don't know who we are, then how are we going to find ourselves to see who we're becoming? You see, there are black people everywhere in the world. We're in America, we're in Jamaica, we're in Japan, we're in China, we're in America, and we're in England. But every black person that you find them tag themselves with another country. I'm black British, I'm black American, I'm Jamaican, I'm African American, I'm this, I'm that. So how many type of black people do we have in this world? That's the question I have for them first. Revolution is sensed as an opportunity of changes. So it's time that we change our perspective for living, our mindset for developing, and it's time that we retrieve the culture that we have lost to foreigners. We see, we look at the Western to have a traditional culture. When we have a culture that we're supposed to build a system that envelope and control the economy, the systems, the development of our own nations, but yet we're always looking elsewhere, thinking that our culture is going to come from there, thinking that our help is going to come from there, thinking that our investment is going to come from somewhere else. Why do you sit on a gold mine and still look for gold? Africa is blessed. It's blessed with different resources, different commodities, different stuff to be able to build our own sustainable economy and create a curriculum balance in our own economy, have a great state governance that will raise humanity with a different dimension. Africa is the UN. Africa is the only continent on this planet that you can have a white person as an African, a Chinese person as an African, an Indian person as an African, a black person as an African, Egyptian, Israeli, you name it. We are the real United Nations. But yet everybody's talking about unity. We can't unite ourselves with 10,000 different dialects. That's not gonna work. The only way we're gonna be able to unite ourselves is to be able to turn our own resources, our own minerals into production, into manufacturing, and industrialize our resources, our own commodities, and then start to build an economy that will make us become sustainable with the global economy. We haven't been able to acquire the world to work for us. We only bring the world to come and take from us. You see, there's a difference in wanting and needing. I don't know if Africa wants or needs, because if it's them wanting, they already have. They have enough resources to survive. But there is something they need to make the resources become refinable, to become, you know, repackaged, to become manufactured again. That is the energy to be able to put plants, to be able to manufacture, create hubs, industrialization, petrochemical clusters, to recycle your own petrochemicals and create energy to sustain your industrial development. For me, I call this education. Some people might call it work, but you don't need to go to university to get degrees to survive. You need to really learn what is around your surrounding, how you can make the best out of it. That is education. Africans need to be educated by their own resources, by their own tradition, by their own culture, by their own state governments. It shouldn't be from the Western. It shouldn't be from Asia. It shouldn't be from anywhere else. If anybody visited Africa, it's because they are coming to congratulate us for how well we have built our nations and our continent, not because they found out that there's gold and oil here, so they're coming to take their share. This is the change that we are asking for the youth of today. This is the revolutionary movement we're talking about. We don't have a fight with anybody. We're not fighting with our fathers, with our leaders. We're just saying that, look, we want to change because we're thinking the likes of the Western for the future of our children's children and our race and our culture to be respected.